What's good, y'all? Rit Sosa coming back at y'all with another banger. And as y'all can see, by the looks of the title and the screen, the build that I'm bringing y'all today is the two-way playmaker, y'all. Now, as you can see, we are going to be making this build out of the power forward position. So you already know that means we are going to be getting the best possible bat setup when it comes to this build. We are going to be able to get the best attribute lineup. And when it comes to this build all around, I'm telling you, it is completely going to shatter every other build version of this. Now, before we get into the actual making of this two-way playmaker, there is something that I need y'all to do. And man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. Be sure to run up those likes. Go ahead and share this banger with your family and friends. And last but not least, be sure to turn on post notifications so y'all can see when I upload every single day. Now, let's go ahead and get into the making of this two-way playmaker. The first thing that you want to go ahead and do is put this under the power forward position. Now, when it comes to the height, with my liking, I'm going to go with 6'8". When it comes to the weight, again, this is all based on preference, but I'm going to hit y'all with 218. And when it comes to the wingspan, I'm going with 7'6", y'all. Now, the body shape that I like is going to be defined, but I'm telling you, if you want to change it, go ahead and do so. Now, let's go ahead and get into the stats. So first, we are going to be touching the finishing category. Go ahead and put your driving layup up to a 92. And when it comes to your driving dunk, that is going to be a 95. Now, when it comes to the post control, this is going to go up to an 81. Or you could even put it up to an 82 or even an 83. Whatever you want to do, but I'm putting it to where I get 15 finishing badges. Now let's go ahead and get into the shooting. So our mid-range shot is going to go up to an 86. Three-point shot is going to be an 81. And when it comes to the free throw, this is going to be a 64 for 14 shooting badges. Now, let's go ahead and get into the playmaking. Pass accuracy is going to go up to a 92. Ball handle is going to go to a 76. And when it comes to our speed with ball, this is going to be up to a 78. But think about it, y'all. All these stats are going to get boosted, so do not worry. Now, when it comes to the defense, max out your interior, perimeter, steal, and your block. And then from there, go ahead and put your defensive rebound up to a 36 for 21 badges. And then on the playmaking, you get 27. So that is really nice. Then what you want to go ahead and do when it comes to the physicals, max out every single thing except your stamina. You're going to put your stamina up to a 70. And that is really OP for this build, considering this bad setup. Now, let's go ahead and get into the takeovers that this build is going to be able to get. So first, we do get the slashing. From there, we are also going to be able to get the sharp shooting. Then we get the lockdown as well as the rim protector takeover. So again, depending on your playstyle as well as your preference, go ahead and pick takeovers based off of that. But I'm going to start it off with spot up precision for my first takeover. The second one, you can definitely consider one of the slashing, but honestly, to be more overpowered, I would highly recommend the lockdown or the rim protecting takeover. Now, I'm going to go with paint intimidation. And as y'all can see, we have made the two-way playmaker, y'all. Giannis comparison, I'm telling you, that's how you know we made this build right. Now, let's go ahead and get into the making of what this build is going to look like at 99. So first, our speed is going to go up to a 90. Acceleration will be an 87. Strength is going to go up to an 85. And our vertical is going to be a 96 with a 78 stamina. Now, when it comes to the defense, interior is going to go up to an 89. Perimeter will be a 91. Steal as well as your block are both going to be 99 with boost. Now, when it comes to the speed with ball and the playmaking, this is going to go up to an 82. Ball handle will be an 80 for those pro dribble moves, and your pass accuracy will be a 96. Now, when it comes to the free throw, this will be in the 70s with boost. Three-point shot is going to be in the 90s with boost. And when it comes to the midi, it's going to be in the high 90s with boost as well. Now, let's go ahead and get into the finishing. Post control is going to go up to an 86. Driving dunk will be a 99. And same thing with your driving layup if you get those finishing boosts. So that is something that you definitely are going to be able to do when it comes to making this build, as well as you're going to be able to want to do that. Now, let's go ahead and get into the finishing badges. The first two I'm throwing on are going to be Posterizer as well as Heatseeker and Hall of Fame. From there, to help up my teammates with their takeover, I'm going with Highlight Film. Now, the bronze badges I like are going to be Acrobat, Puckback Boss, and honestly, Lob City Finisher is going to be the wave to go, y'all. Now, let's go ahead and get into the shooting. We got 14 badges to work with here. So, the first one that I'm going to throw on is going to be Hot Zone Hunter as well as Hot Shot on Hall of Fame. Now, with these last 7 badges, it's really going to be all based on your own preference. But what I'm going to do is go with Catch and Shoot on Silver as well as Corner Specialist. From there, I'm also going to go with Clutch Shooter as well as Green Machine. And you could really upgrade any of these badges that you already have on if that's the route you want to go. I'm telling you, as long as you revolve around Hotshot and Hot Zone Hunter, you will be good. Now, let's go ahead and get into the playmaking. We got 27 badges to work with here, so I'm going to go ahead and start it off with Quick First Step on Hall of Fame, as well as Handles for Days. Now, with these last 19 badges, it really comes down to your play style. So for mine, if you want to break ankles, go ahead and put on Space Creator, but if you want to help out your teammates more and get the team takeover quicker, go ahead and put on Special Delivery. Now, I like a couple different bronze badges. Those are going to be Unpluckable as well as Bailout. From there, I'm going to go with Gold Stop and Go. And now, I'm going to go with Hall of Fame Downhill, or you could go with Floor General and Dimer. But again, if you want to change up any of these setups, you definitely can. I personally like to break ankles, so I'm going with Space Creator. And the last one is going to be Silver Tight Handles. Now, let's go ahead and get into the defense. We got 21 badges to work with right here. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is put on Intimidator on Hall of Fame as well as Gold Clamps. Now with these last couple of badges, I'm going to be real with y'all. There is a couple different routes that you can take when it comes to doing this. But for my liking, I'm going to go with Rim Protector on Hall of Fame. Now I'm telling you, there are going to be a couple of bronze badges that you need to consider when it comes to any single attribute as well as any single badge category. So when it comes to the defense, the bronze badges I'm going to consider are going to be Chase Down Artist as well as Interceptor. Any other ones right here are going to be ones that I recommend you upgrade from bronze, y'all. So as long as you put these on Silver, Gold, or even Hall of Fame, you will be good. But I'm telling you, if you want to even go the route of spreading the wealth, that is something that I feel like is really going to be nice, because you're going to have a nice balance of different badges, and you're going to have more than the normal amount of defensive badges, because you're going to have more badges activating at once, and that is a huge plus, especially when it comes to the defense. But again, I really enjoy ankle braces on Hall of Fame. I'm going to go ahead and leave it like this. You could change it up, but that's a setup of 15, 14, 27, and 21. Thank y'all for watching this entire video through, but more so, thank y'all for having me a part of y'all day. Shout out to the Rich Gang family. I love y'all. I thank y'all. And man, y'all already know what y'all need to do. Be sure to hit that sub button if you're new. To the Rich Gang family, as well as any new supporters, be sure to run up those likes. Go ahead and share this banger with your family and friends. And last, but definitely not least, be sure to turn on post notice so y'all can see when I upload every single day. Man, with all that being said, I got one last thing to say. Rich out.